Forsake me not, O Lord. Be not far from me. Make haste and come to my help. O Lord, my strong salvation. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. Friends, I welcome you to our Mass today. It's the 31st Sunday of the year. Our intentions for the Mass today, we have Siobhan McKeever's second anniversary, and we have Patrick, Adelaide, and Kevin Tomalte. Michael Tweet, anniversary, Baby Marie Rose Kelly, Vincent and Bridget Holdsgrove, and deceased family members. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord. Let perpetual light shine upon them. May their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed, to the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. We come to Mass knowing that God loves us. No matter what, he loves every one of us. Just as he loved the man in the gospel today, Zacchaeus, when everyone else indeed despised him. But the Lord never does that. You're sent to heal the contrite of heart, Lord of mercy. You came to call sinners, Christ of mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us, Lord of mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Glory to God. And on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Take away the sin of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and the glory of God the Father. Amen. And let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, by whose gift your faithful offer you right and praiseworthy service, grant, we pray, that we may hasten without stumbling to receive the things you have promised. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
First reading, a reading from the Book of Wisdom. In your sight, Lord, the whole world is like a grain of dust that tips the scales, like a drop of morning dew falling on the ground. Yet you are merciful to all, because you can do all things and overlook men's sins so that they can repent. Yes, you love all that exists. You hold nothing of what you have made in abhorrence. For had you hated anything, you would not have formed it. And how, had you not willed it, could a thing persist? How be conserved if not called forth by you? You spare all things because all things are yours. Lord, lover of life, you whose imperishable spirit is in all, little by little, therefore, you correct those who offend. You admonish and remind them of how they have sinned, so that they may abstain from evil and trust in you, Lord. The word of the Lord. Responsorial Psalm. I will bless your name forever, O God, my King. Bless your name forever, O God, my King. I will give you glory, O God, my King. I will bless your name forever. I will bless you day after day and praise your name forever. I will bless your name forever, O God, my King. The Lord is kind and full of compassion, slow to anger, abounding in love. How good is the Lord to all, compassionate to all his creatures. I will bless your name forever, O God, my King. All your creatures shall thank you, O Lord, and your friends shall repeat their blessing. They shall speak of the glory of your reign and declare your might, O God. I will bless your name forever, O God, my King. The Lord is faithful in all his words and loving in all his deeds. The Lord supports all who fall and raises all who are bowed down. I will bless your name forever, O God, my King. The second reading, a reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We pray continually that our God will make you worthy of his call and by his power fulfill all your desires for goodness and complete all that you have been doing through faith. Because in this way, the name of our Lord Jesus Christ will be glorified in you and you in him, by the grace of our God and the Lord Jesus Christ. To turn now, brothers, to the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ and how we shall all be gathered round him. Please do not get excited too soon or alarmed by any prediction or rumor or any letter claiming to come from us, implying that the day of the Lord has already arrived. The word of the Lord. Gospel acclamation. Alleluia, alleluia. Blessings on the King who comes in the name of the Lord. Praise in heaven and glory in the highest heavens. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus entered Jericho and was going through the town when a man whose name was Zacchaeus made his appearance. He was one of the senior tax collectors and a wealthy man. He was anxious to see what kind of man Jesus was, but he was too short and could not see him for the crowd. So he ran ahead and climbed a sycamore tree to catch a glimpse of Jesus, who was to pass that way. When Jesus reached the spot, he looked up and spoke to him. Zacchaeus, come down. Hurry, because I must stay at your house today. And he hurried down and welcomed him joyfully. They all complained when they saw what was happening. He has gone to stay at a sinner's house, they said. But Zacchaeus stood his ground and said to the Lord, Look, sir, I'm going to give half my property to the poor, and if I have cheated anybody, I will pay him back four times the amount. And Jesus said to him, Today, salvation has come to this house, because this man too is a son of Abraham, for the Son of Man has come to seek out and save what was lost. And this is the gospel of the Lord. I think this story of Zacchaeus is one of the most familiar gospel stories. It's the very text that normally teachers use in preparing the children for their first confession and then first communion. And the little ones, I think, they like it very much. They are always intrigued by this gospel. There are certain elements, vivid details that they easily resonate even with us as well. You have this unpopular tax collector. He is short of stature, too short to see Jesus, but he wanted to see Jesus. And what does he do? He climbs a sycamore tree to get a better view, and no one would see him there, he thought. He's an interesting character, this man Zacchaeus. He's in a job that has brought him a lot of money, but clearly his conscience is at him. He's not satisfied with everything. He's not satisfied even with his job. He's looking for something more, something deeper, like many of us too. And as a tax collector, Zacchaeus would have been considered a hate figure, of course, a sinner. He would be a recognized sinner. He'd be despised because he would be with the enemy, you might say, with the Romans, working for them. But something extraordinary happened. It created a shock, even among the onlookers. When Jesus got just beneath the tree, he looks up and something happens strange, completely unexpected. He invites Zacchaeus home. He even calls him by name, which is very unusual. Zacchaeus, he said, come down. I must stay at your house today. So Jesus opened the way, opened the door now. And Jesus, though, was going against all the social and religious expectations of his time. The others would have nothing to do with this man at all. Not Jesus. In this story, it's significant that Jesus invites Zacchaeus into table fellowship even before he decides to mend his ways and make restitution to those he has cheated. And he does all these things. A wonderful, you might say, confession, you know, and restitution. Zacchaeus welcomes Jesus to his house with open arms. And think the very experience of being accepted, of Jesus' love, transforms him. And to know that someone believes in us, you know, it makes all the difference, does it not? All the difference in the world. Several years ago, a school teacher assigned to visit children in a large city hospital received a routine call that she visit a particular child. And she took the child's, it was a boy, the boy's name, his room number, and was told by the teacher on the other end of the line, we're studying nouns and adverbs in his class now. I'd be grateful if you would help him with his homework so he doesn't fall behind the others. So the teacher just followed those instructions. She got to the hospital and then she asked for the ward and for the boy and so on. And then she discovered when she went there that he was in one of these burn units. This little boy was very, very badly burnt. And then she was in beside him in the ward, in his room, and she didn't know what to do or what to say now, because he was all bandaged up and so on. How could she even talk to him? She didn't know what to say, but she eventually said, look, he said, I'm here to help you with your nouns and adjectives. Could you imagine that happening? But something happened here. She did that. She spoke to the little boy, and she was a bit disturbed herself. And when she left, she was called back by the matron of the ward or something, and she thought there was something wrong here. And she tried to excuse herself and so on, but the nurse said, "You don't understand," she said. "You don't understand. We've been very worried about this boy, but ever since you were here yesterday, his whole attitude has changed. You know, he's fighting back now. He's responding to treatment. It's as though he has decided to live." Later on, this same boy explained that he had completely given up hope until he saw that teacher. It all changed when he came to this simple realization. And with tears, he expressed it like this. They wouldn't send a teacher to work on nouns and adverbs with a dying boy, would they? No. Even the little boy realized. He realized something was here. Changed him, believed now that something could happen, that he would get better. And he did, of course. Jesus believed in Zacchaeus. He seemed to be a hopeless case too. He seemed, but he wasn't. No one wanted to do anything with him, but Jesus did. And it's very often interesting and encouraging for all of us to notice how Jesus treated people, whether it be the woman in the streets or the tax collector in the tree. He saw something no one else could see. He looked deeper into the real person. That's how Jesus looks upon all of us as sinners. Our sins is not the barrier. It's not that will stop Jesus seeking us. Like, Jesus was even more eager to see Zacchaeus than Zacchaeus was to see him. The question, I think, is not, how am I to find God? But how am I to let myself be found by God? Let us be found by God and see what will happen to us as well. We stand and pray together the Nicene Creed. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation he came down from heaven. By the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. So now we bring our prayers, but with confidence to the Father who created us, who loves us, and who is full of love, kindness, and compassion for all his children.
As we listen to today's gospel, let us make a commitment that, like Zacchaeus, we will strive to overcome all worldly obstacles, to be close to Jesus, and invite him more and more into our lives. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray that our church be a community of solidarity, fraternity, and welcome for all, breathing new life in the spirit of synodality. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for a spirit of unity in our country and in our communities, and that God will destroy all divisions that separate the human family, helping us recognize his love is our true source of life. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
On this coming Tuesday, the Feast of All Saints, we revere those who have lived their lives in the footsteps of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. And we pray that through following their example, we ourselves may gain the rewards which the Lord has bestowed on them. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
On this Wednesday, All Souls Day, we remember in our prayers all those who have gone before us in faith, especially those of our own families and of this parish, that they may stand with the saints in glory, close to Christ, who died to assure their salvation. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We bow our heads and remember in silence our own personal intentions and the intentions of those who have asked for our prayers. Lord, hear us.
And again, let's include in our prayers our deceased. And today, remembering, of course, Siobhan, and Patrick and Adelaide and Kevin Tumulty and Michael Tweet and Mairead Rose Kelly and Vincent and Bridget as well. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord. Let perpetual light shine upon them. May they rest in peace. Father, we make these prayers to you, reaching out in confidence, knowing the love and compassion you have for all your children. We make these prayers through Christ our Lord. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May these sacrificial gifts, O Lord, become for you a pure oblation, and for us a holy outpouring of your mercy, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Thank you. And the Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body, we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so, with all the angels, we praise you as in joyful celebration we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, with Eamon, Michael, our Bishop, and all indeed who minister in the church. Remember your servants who remember especially in our Mass today. And remember also our dear brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with St. Joseph, her blessed spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. Now we have the privilege of speaking to our Heavenly Father in words that Jesus left us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Pray for peace. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. And the peace of the Lord be with you always. And Our Lady, Queen of Peace, pray for us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. And may this mingling of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring eternal life to us who receive it. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. And may the body of Christ keep us safe now for eternal life. just mention a couple of the notices in the parish bulletin. We are asked to pray, and we do now very much, for the happy repose of our recently deceased, for Anya Ford, Nee Dahl, for Winfred, or Winnie Mullen, Nee Woods, and Seamus Waters. May they rest in peace. And remembering our dead, we have the Remembrance Mass, Sunday evening, the 6th of November, here in St. Bridget's Church at 7 p.m., where we will be remembering our daily departed. There will be refreshments served afterwards in the Resource Centre. And a thank you to all the teachers, the parents, children, the beautiful banner, the hamper, and the offertory gifts and music at last week's Harvest Thanksgiving Mass. Our communion antiphon. You will show me the path of life, the fullness of joy in your presence, O Lord. And let us pray. May the working of your power, O Lord, increase in us, we pray, so that renewed by these heavenly sacraments, we may be prepared by your gift for receiving what they promise. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. And the Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Our Mass has ended. Go in peace, though, to love, to serve the Lord.